Good morning. Welcome to Arlington Street Church, gathered in love and service for justice and peace. Welcome to the soul of Sunday. We are Unitarian Universalists. Ours is an historic faith with a progressive theology. We affirm the worth and dignity of every being, and that we are all deeply interconnected. We are bound to one another, not by creed, but by covenant. And we are called to love with open minds and open hearts and open hands. Whoever you are, those of all nations, all creeds, all colors, all kinds of love, you are welcome here. As we gather, we acknowledge that Arlington Street Church occupies the ancestral homeland of the Massachusetts. By making this land acknowledgement, we recognize, honor, and affirm the sovereignty of all First Nations people. Before I light our chalice today, I will read a poem by American poet Joy Sullivan, called Instructions for Traveling West. Instructions for Traveling West. First, you must realize you're homesick for all the lives you're not living. Then you must commit to the road and the rising loneliness, to the sincere thrill of coming apart. Divorce yourself from routine and control. Instead, find a desert and fall in. Take the trail that promises a view, get lost, break your toes, bruise your knees, keep going. Watch a purple meadow quiver, get still, pet trail dogs, buy the hat, run out of gas, befriend strangers. Knight yourself every morning for your newborn courage. Give grief her own lullaby. Drink whiskey beside a 100-year-old cactus. Honor everything. Pray to something unnameable. Fall for someone impractical. Reacquaint yourself with desire and all her slender hands. Bear beauty for as long as you are able. And if you spot a sunning warbler glowing like a prism, remind yourself, joy is not a trick.
Keep no score.
Good morning. Welcome to our Zoomers, and welcome to the congregation gathered in person. I'm Cal Alford. Reverend Beth is on summer sabbatical, as is Director of Music Mark David Buckles and the Arlington Street Church Choir. Reverend Parisa will lead us in worship in September. Ali Jablonski and I are joined by Youngju Young and Sam LaGrego. Thank you, friends. And a very special thanks to all our volunteers here in the sanctuary today, tech team, greeters, ushers, and coffee hour hosts. If you're new, we're so glad to have you here. If you'd like to know more about Arlington Street, please visit ascboston.org. There's a link where you can sign up for our weekly e-newsletter called The Snapshot, which will resume this fall. Whether you've been coming here for years or today is your first day, your first time at Arlington Street, welcome home.
Good morning. A warm welcome to this morning's preacher, Cal Alford. Cal is a second-year Master of Divinity candidate at Boston University and has had the privilege of serving as student minister at Arlington Street. For the past 37 years, before returning to graduate school, Cal worked as a creative entrepreneur, pattern maker, and graphic designer, fostering creative expression in every facet of life, believing deeply in the power of art, design, and commerce to make the world a more beautiful, humane, and meaning-filled place. Cal has made a lifelong commitment to integrate the arts into everyday life and understands the uplifting power of the arts and arts education to infuse all we do with meaning, purpose, and possibility. Cal is color and type obsessed, a pattern hunter and maker, professional noticer, miner of meaning, lover of metaphor, and pun-loving copywriter. Cal is also a mom to four lovely individuals and grandma named KK to two new sprouts, as well as being a friend, mentor, partner, sister, daughter, and maker of all things food, fabric, and paper. Cal is marked by an inclination to plan, explore, be dedicated, and work well with others. Post-graduation, Cal hopes to weave together her reverence for creativity as a spiritual practice with her longing to be of service into a tapestry of community, art, healing, and wholeness. Welcome home, Cal. If you haven't already downloaded today's order of service, it's available in the chat and on the homepage at ascboston.org. For our guests here in the sanctuary, there are printed copies at the great doors. It is maybe not as hot today, but still a hot summer here in Boston, and we know that we don't have air conditioning. There are pitchers of cold water in the back. Please help yourself at any time during the service, and if at any time you need help, our ushers are here to support you. Let's do all we can to take care of one another. As we begin our greetings, I invite the Zoomers and those here in the sanctuary with a device handy to please say hello in the chat and tell us where you are Zooming in from today. And now Rich is going to turn the camera on the in-person congregation as we wave and smile at each other as well as our friends in the Zoom room. And you all in the Zoom room can wave and smile back. Hello, friends. Let's all engage that Arlington Street spirit of welcome that transcends physical distance as we greet one another heart to heart. Our opening hymn is number 347, Gather the Spirit. The words can be found in the order of service, in the chat, and the gray hymnal. Let's rise now in body, rise in spirit, and sing together.
Gather the Spirit, harvest the power. separate fires will kindle one flame. Witness the mystery of this hour. Our trials in light appear all the same. Gather in peace, gather in thanks, gather in sympathy now and then. Gather in hope, compassion and strength. Gather to celebrate once again. Gather the spirit of heart and mind. Seeds for the sowing are laid in store. Nurtured in love and conscience refined, with body and spirit united once more. Gather in peace, gather in thanks, gather in sympathy now and then. Gather in hope, compassion and strength. Gather to celebrate once again. Gather the spirit growing in all, drawn by the moon and fed by the sun. Winter to spring and summer to fall, the chorus of life resounding as one. Gather in peace, gather in thanks, gather in sympathy now and then. Gather in hope, compassion and strength. Gather to celebrate once again. Open my heart to be a sanctuary, all made holy, loved and true. With thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
I invite you to be seated for our time for treasured ritual and sharing community candles of sorrow and joy. These candles were submitted on our website by the Friday evening deadline. If you didn't submit your candle and have a joy or sorrow to share this morning, please type it into the chat. Zoomers are invited to light silent candles at home. Those in the sanctuary are invited to light a silent candle at the table up front to the right of the Gleason podium. In addition to sharing our sorrows and joys this morning, let's reach out to one another in the week ahead, staying connected. May these times remind us of how very precious this beloved spiritual community is. We need one another. Whether together or apart, may we stay very close. And now, in the spirit of invocation, let's join in singing Sanctuary. The words are printed in your order of service and in the chat.
Open my heart to be a sanctuary, all made holy, loved and true.
Some of us come today with heavy hearts. We open our hearts to you.
We have one candle of sorrow today from the Arlington Street community at the passing of Frank Mangan, who died on August 12th in hospice care. Frank was a professor at the Stockbridge School of Agriculture. A major focus of his work was to promote growing and marketing vegetables and herbs popular among immigrant communities in Massachusetts. Frank worked hard to assess community needs, build relationships at all levels of his work, and work collaboratively for the greater good. Frank enjoyed many hobbies, including keeping his own vegetable garden and sharing his produce with friends. We hold Frank's spouse, Martha, in loving kindness and send our care to all who love Frank. Frank Presente.
Open my heart to be a sanctuary, all made holy, loved and true, with thanksgiving I'll be a living sanctuary.
Some of us come today in joy. We share your joy.
From Harriet Hury, a candle of deep gratitude for my own healing and the healing of others. Harriet, we celebrate your healing with you and continue to send you our love. From Barbara Gindhart, a candle of joy for my Special Olympics team, the Dachshunds, who won the silver medal at the State Division Championship softball game. This is their first silver medal, and I am so proud of them. Congratulations to the Dachshunds and to Coach Barbara. A final candle of joy from the Arlington Street congregation. Congratulations to Bill Briggs on this joyous celebration of his 30th anniversary at Arlington Street. Just stick around, Bill, only 5 more years to go to beat Reverend Kim's record.
Open my heart to be a sanctuary. All made holy, loved and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Open my heart to be a sanctuary. All made holy, loved and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
For all the sorrows and all the joys we hold in our hearts, we light a silent candle to remember and to rejoice. May the peace of this sanctuary enter into our hearts as we share a quiet moment together, breathing our prayers for ourselves, for one another, and for the world. Amen.
Let's join now in saying together the affirmation and covenant of this beloved spiritual community. The words are printed in your order of service and in the chat. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and service is our gift. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to speak our truths in love, and to help one another. El amor es el espíritu de nuestra congregación, y el servicio es nuestro regalo. Esto es a lo que nos comprometemos, convivir en paz, hablar nuestras verdades con amor, y ayudarnos los unos a los otros. Our next hymn is number 346, Come Sing a Song with Me. The words can be found in the order of service, in the chat, and in the gray hymnal. Let's rise in body, rise in spirit, and sing together.
Come sing a song with me. Come sing a song with me. Come sing a song with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come dream a dream with me. Come dream a dream with me. Come dream a dream with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come walk in rain with me. Come walk in rain with me. Come walk in rain with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time. Come share a rose with me. Come share a rose with me. Come share a rose with me, that I might know your mind. And I'll bring you hope when hope is hard to find. And I'll bring a song of love and a rose in the winter time.
Welcome home. Welcome home. These words may be the sweetest, most soothing, most emotionally grounding greetings we humans can share. Welcome home. These words are a core and cherished part of our weekly service here at Arlington Street, welcoming people to a place that we sincerely hope feels like open arms ready for a hug. Safe, loving, comforting, a place at long last to be yourself. I distinctly remember the first time, just a few years ago, I heard Reverend Kim say these words from this pulpit during my first visit here. It's like she was saying them to me alone. Whether you've been coming here for years or today is your first time at Arlington Street, welcome home. It was my first time here, and those words were a most reassuring antidote. At that time, I was feeling a profound sense of homesickness. I was a new student in a new city, in her first apartment, with a new understanding of herself, far, far, far from anything that resembled home. I imagine many of you, like me, suffered some degree of homesickness as a child. For me, it was summer camp, childhood sleepovers, overnights with my grandparents. These were at first the eagerly anticipated adventures of my restless and curious little girl self, but they rather dissolved quickly into confused days and nights filled with feelings of physical ache, dread, and loneliness. My hopes for these exciting adventures dulled, slipping, just out of reach. Even as a child, I think my brave little girl understood that my homesickness was more than a childish brush with emotional immaturity. I sensed that my feelings were a little more than simply missing a physical place, my childhood home. I wanted home, yes, and I also longed for my mom, my mom's cooking, my bed, my books, my desk, my dog, my closet, my street, my pear tree. It was also much more spiritually and psychologically complicated than I could understand at that time. Almost anything can bring on a feeling of homesickness. And during my childhood, and during the last 2 years here in Boston, almost everything did. A name, a word, a smell, a taste, a memory, a touch, even a color. The feeling of homesickness is just dreadful, really. And to experience the reverberating emotional echo of it as an adult has been deeply unsettling and isolating for me. Like the aching phantom limb of some unknown hurt. With all the best intentions of helping, colleagues, friends, and family have showered me over the past few years with milquetoast platitudes such as, home is where the heart is, or your higher power is your home, or wherever you go, you are home. Even though I had ventured out, gone on the move towards something new and unknown, away from almost everything familiar, let me assure you, these simplistic sentiments did precious little to comfort me. Today we are a people on the move, though. The 21st century has seen more people uprooting themselves and moving to a new city or a new country than at any other point in our history. A Gallup World Poll published in December 2018 found that 15% of the world's adults would move to another country if they had the opportunity. That's 750 million people ready to pack their bags and leave their hometowns. That's a lot of people who could be at serious risk for the debilitating effects of homesickness. And what about our relationship to home and homesickness post-pandemic today? In the early days of COVID, we'll all remember, some of us were stranded away from home, abroad in school, traveling for work, desperate to get a return flight home. Others found lonely isolation, confined within the same four walls of home, to be more than they could stand. This recent common experience, it seems to me, perfectly articulates the confounding paradox embedded in the metaphors of home and homesickness. In her book, Homesickness, An American History, American historian Dr. Susan Matt uncovers a fascinating hidden history of homesickness in the United States. She writes, during my research, I visited a lot of archives, and every single archive I went to, I never came away empty-handed. Once you start looking for it, homesickness is really written all over American history. To grasp the insight of Susan Matt's research into our history of homesickness, let's first begin by understanding the etymology and genealogy of the word nostalgia. Nostalgia is a word first coined by a 17th century German physician, Johann Hofer. Nostalgia comes from the Greek words nostos, meaning homecoming, and algos, meaning pain. In other words, nostalgia originally meant homesickness. But it was not being used in Hofer's time to describe an emotion. From the 17th to the 19th century, nostalgia was seen by doctors as a serious medical condition. It included a range of symptoms, both physical and mental, fever, fatigue, digestive complaints, and depression. This homesickness at the time was actually known to cause death. If we'd all taken our homesick childhood selves back to the 18th century, we would have felt seen and heard and been greeted with some sympathetic knowing nods by our doctors. 1688 was the first time nostalgia was mentioned in the medical literature. And it was described poetically by Hofer as the grief of the lost charm of the native land. Hofer traced its physical manifestation in our bodies along uncommon routes through the untouched courses of the channels of the brain to the body. Wow. Was Hofer describing what we now know is our polyvagal system? Sounds like it. He was indeed a man ahead of his time. Nostalgia, that is homesickness, as a medical condition was documented widely during the American Civil War. In her book, Susan Matt documents more than 5,200 cases recorded, including on the Union side, 74 deaths from homesickness. It was a similar scenario to the homesickness epidemic during the French Revolution, and this homesickness in America was viewed as a very real threat to the American troops. So much so that certain songs believed to be triggers for domestic yearning or possible desertion were banned. They included Home Sweet Home, the most popular song of the time, and Auld Lang Syne. By the earliest part of the 20th century, however, homesickness as a medical condition, interestingly, fell out of favor in American culture, as it was believed to be incongruent with the growing forces of capitalism that were taking hold. In an economy that needed more mobile workers, Susan Matt explains there was no place for a medical condition that kept people tied to the place they were born. Susan Matt concludes that during the American Civil War, homesickness was a noble condition because it signified your love of wife or mother or child or place, and it signified your rootedness. These were all seen as virtues. It was also a signal of your sensitivity. But by the 20th century, in the age of corporate capitalism, it became a weakness. Homesickness didn't disappear, but it did get shoved underground, morphed into no more than a pesky emotion as it fell out of medical use. Another set of current and ongoing geopolitical circumstances that has perpetuated a serious new epidemic of suffering and global homesickness are immigrants and refugees as they flee war and persecution and poverty all over the world, and are either forced out or rush away from their beloved homes in a nomadic search for safety, security, and a new place to call home. Psychotherapist Sarah Temple Smith works for the British Refugee Council, which provides help for child refugees in the UK. She emphasizes the idea of home as a complicated one that permeates every part of our lives. She says, we talk about loss of home for refugees as an existential loss. When a young person sits in the therapy room and their body slumps and tears roll down their face, that's what they're experiencing. If you've lost your home, you've lost everything. To have your home shut its doors to you for whatever reason, it's like someone cut off your legs. You can no longer stand upright. You can no longer move yourself. It's a loss of attachment in an absolute sense of being part of your world. Temple Smith explains that home incorporates far more than the buildings you grew up in. It also is more than the family and community relationships that you enjoyed. Home is how we relate to everything around us. And homesickness represents the trauma of the loss of how we relate to everything around us. Alas, it's quite simply something that will never leave us. Homesickness is still very real, very complex, and very powerful emotion. An aching longing for something we can't quite name. A sense of displacement or exile from a place or a state of being that we yearn to return to. We can be debilitatingly homesick for a place, for a community, for a way of life, for lives not lived, for a person loved, and for people lost. So if we know that homesickness will remain our perpetual companion, how will we befriend her? How will we navigate the spiritual wilderness she will get us lost in? And how will we find our way back home? First, let's acknowledge our homesickness, honor it, and recognize it as a part of our core human nature. Let us allow ourselves to feel the longing, feel the ache, feel the sense of loss without judgment or resistance. Let's recognize that homesickness is not a weakness or a failure, but a sign of our deep desire for something more free, something more real, something more safe, something more dependable. Let's use these desires and longings as the energy we'll need to explore this wilderness of our own hearts and souls, looking for what we are missing to feel at home in the world. This will invariably involve facing difficult emotions, confronting our doubts and our fears, and letting go of old patterns and beliefs that no longer serve us. Alas, it will be neither simple, nor easy, nor avoidable. So when you sense homesickness coming to visit, that existential, empty, heart-sick longing, and she will come to visit, in all likelihood, as she did again for me this year, remember to take a pause, take a breath, look for her, and take her hand. All she wants is for you to lead her, to lead you both back home to community, back home to vocation, to place, back to a new way of being, and back to a new understanding of yourself, your real, original self, the one person who can give yourself, your community, and the world your own gift of redefining and reimagining what home really is and what home really means, one secure attachment at a time. As you walk with homesickness hand in hand, walk with kindness, walk with curiosity and creativity, walk with patience and understanding. and walk with a sense of humor and a deep love for her longing. And now, I may have some advice that even I can believe in. I think that maybe home is where you hold hands with your longing. Welcome home, one and all. Amen.
Hello, I'm Sam. I'd like to introduce the anthem real quick. I know it's not in the order of service, so I'll now enlighten everyone on that mystery. The song we're about to play for you is Times Like These by the Foo Fighters. And as soon as I heard that today's sermon would be about befriending homesickness, I knew this would be the perfect song to choose because Dave Grohl wrote this song about his own experience with feeling very homesick on tour with the Foo Fighters and how coping with those feelings led him to have a deeper love and appreciation for his home, his friends, and his loved ones. So, without further ado, this is Times Like These by the Foo Fighters.
Times like these you learn to live again.
times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these you give and give again.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sam and Youngju. Arlington Street is entirely self-sustaining. It's up to us, and our generosity continues to be astounding. Thank you for your commitment to our staff, our building, and our beloved spiritual community. Each Sunday, we share our collection plate with a partner in our mission of love, justice, service, and peace. During the summer months, our Share the Plate offerings are saved to use for future emergencies and to help in rescue and rebuilding efforts following natural and unnatural disasters, amplifying our impact around the world. Recently, as I was in the receiving line after service, someone came up to me. "I could use your help." They went on to let me know they knew of someone who had lost all their furniture in a crisis. "I thought you might have an idea of how to help," they said to me. As a minister, that's one of my most important roles, to help. It can be an overwhelming responsibility. I started trying to think of how we might help them find furniture, and then how in Boston we might be able to move the furniture. I have a used Mini Cooper that can fit very little. It took one brainstorming call to an ASC member and we found a couch. It took one call to an ASC couple to find a truck. This person who had been through a tough time now has a beautiful and comfortable couch, and maybe even more important, this person has been helped. The responsibility of helping is not anywhere near as overwhelming when you have company. Being a part of the Arlington community both inspires me to help and ensures that I am never helping alone. Arlington, all of you, Arlington Street makes me a better person and helps me make our world better. Please take a moment now to join me in giving to sustain our beloved Arlington Street. You can give online at ascboston.org or check the order of service for instructions for how to give via QR code, Venmo, or text message. You can also mail a check to the church or use the envelopes in the pews, which can be given to the ushers as they come through with collection plates. Thank you for your generosity. Thank you, Youngju. If you'd like more Arlington Street in your week, please go to ascboston.org. There are weekly gatherings in the Zoom room for loving kindness, meditation, poetry, yoga, and writing. Join me and Reverend John in the ASC Zoom room for Summer Tea for Times of Change, each Wednesday at 5 o'clock, as we all navigate a season of change together. This week's question is, tell us about a person or a moment that changed your life. Bring your tea or your favorite beverage and be in community. We need one another and all are welcome. Next Sunday's preacher is Rebecca Reed. Rebecca is a third generation Unitarian Universalist. She grew up attending the Unitarian Church of Sharon and is now on the worship committee at Arlington Street and sings in the choir. Rebecca is a middle school special education English teacher entering her 8th year of teaching in Boston this fall. She loves to teach herself how to play piano and enjoys long walks around the city. More information and Zoom room links are at ascboston.org. To attend any of them, you don't have to be a member, you don't have to turn on your video or talk if you don't want to, and they're all free. All are always welcome. Following the service, everyone is welcome to join the virtual coffee hour. If you'd like to participate, please answer yes to the breakout room invitation that will appear on your screen. If you're here in the sanctuary, you'll need to go to the Zoom room before the postlude begins. If you're here in person following the service, we'll gather in the Honeywell Chapel for a live chat coffee hour, right through the leather door to the right of the pulpit. Thanks to all who joined in today's service and to all who made it possible. Remember, we're in this together. I love you. Our final hymn is number 1064, Blue Boat Home. The words can be found in your order of service, in the chat, and in the teal hymnal. Let's rise in body, rise in spirit, and sing together.
Is the ocean I travel, and the earth.
as my blue boat home.
Thank you. Before our benediction, I invite those of you in the Zoom room to please reach your hands and touch the sides of your virtual square. And those of you in the sanctuary to please raise your hands, palm out. Let's send loving kindness to the people on the left and the right of you, and send loving kindness to the person on either side of them. Send out love into this beloved spiritual community and feel it coming back to you. Love is the spirit of this congregation. And now for our benediction, I invite you to put your hands together over your heart in namaste. I bow to the divine in you. Beloved spiritual companions, homesick, heartsick, hesitant, and reluctant wanderers, let's begin here at Arlington Street to do what we can to feel at home in the world with each other, whether we're friends or strangers, and with ourselves, whether we feel rooted or untethered. As we leave here today, may we all take with us the blessing of being welcomed home, a feeling that wraps us in warmth, sustenance, shelter, accompaniment, and safety. May we all find our way home, home to ourselves, home to one another, home to the sacred, however we understand it. And may we do so with courage, with grace, and with an open heart. In this remembering of home, let's also remember joy is not a trick. May it be so. Amen. Let us keep the faith, beloveds, and pass it on. The service begins when the service ends. Bless your hearts. I love you. Amen.
please visit ascboston.org for more information about this historic Unitarian Universalist congregation. Arlington Street Church, gathered in love and service for justice and peace.